In the 1940s, Will Eisner believed that comics were an art. And at that point, nobody believed comics were an art.
You know, one thing I really admired about Will was that he was able to make a great cocktail out of the ambitions that his parents had for him. Comics are an interesting arena for this, you know, because they're that place where commerce and art get to spawn their bastard children.
The fact that he had ownership in the spirit was pretty much unprecedented. You can count on one hand the cartoonists who owned or were able to acquire the rights to their own strip.
And what Eisner did, which was so radical, was to introduce genuine agony, real pain.
They were just like the great Humphrey Bogart, Lauren Bacall movies, the wonderful film noir movies.
Pacing, the way that he used time, the way that he introduced cinematic techniques, the idea of the camera angles, all of these things were that first gateway that Will offered us into how comics could evolve and change.
Looking at the city as a living, breathing creature, the people interacting with it, his ability to capture that was inspiring in terms of viewing the city yet again anew.
Well, Will Eisner essentially invented the graphic novel, I would say, or at least he was the first artist, writer to take it really seriously.
Me and many other cartoonists of my generation really took notice. For the first time, I started thinking what I did is not periodicals, but as things that would sit on a shelf and have a life forever.
This is a story about people who go through life, do great things, and never mention. People have moments of glory that other people never know anything about.